Hello, welcome to Learning Every Day with me, Lisa Aaron. This channel will benefit teachers, homeschoolers, and students of all ages. I'm here to help you learn. Join our learning circle and subscribe. Today we're going to be learning about graphs. Graphs show us information as a visual image or picture that we turn into data.
Data is a term that means information.
Graphs help us organize, represent, and interpret data. We're able to see and make calculations and understand numbers more clearly in a visual sense. It also increases our vocabulary because
when you use graphs, you use a variety of terms. Together, we will see some of these terms as we move through this lesson.
We use words like altogether, fewest, equal, more, greater, least, how many, and much more. In this lesson, you'll be hearing some of these terms. Come along, enjoy this lesson with me, and listen for these words. Let's begin.
Learning about graphing. A graph can be defined as a pictorial representation or diagram that represents data or values in an organized manner. The points on the graph or bars can represent relationships between two or more things. These things I call variables. Variables can be many things. Anything has a relationship to each other.
Interpret and analyze. We're going to be looking at pictorial graphs, tally graphs, bar graphs, pie graphs, and line graphs. Pictorial graphs. A pictograph can also be called a pictogram or a picture chart. It is a visual representation of data that uses pictures, icons, and relative sizes to highlight data, patterns, and trends. How is this information presented? A pictograph is made. We can look at the data by looking at the ice cream cones. The graph shows chocolate, vanilla, strawberry, mint, and chocolate chip, Rocky Road, and cherry. We can see how many cones were eaten. Let's look at another example. Number of teeth lost in school
classrooms.
We have the teachers on the left, Miss Doyle, Mrs. Bowers, Mr. Andrews, Mrs. Aaron, and Miss Fernandez. On the right, we see the teeth, but
whenever we have data in front of us, we need to look at the key or the legend to see the values of what the symbols mean. Here we have teeth. The tooth on the bottom equals 2.
In Miss Doyle's class, we have 4 teeth, so we have to go 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 teeth were lost in Miss Doyle's class. What about Mr. Andrews' class? 1 tooth is there, so it would equal 2. 2 teeth. What about Ms. Fernandez's class? Look closely. We have 3.5 teeth. We have 1 tooth, 2, 2nd tooth, 4, 3rd tooth, 6, and then it would be a half, so it would be just worth 1. 7. 7 teeth were lost in Ms. Fernandez's class.
Let's answer the question at the top of the graph.
Tell me the amount each group of teeth represent on this graph. Always begin by looking at the value first when figuring out amounts. If the picture is divided, such as that tooth, this represents half the value. Ms. Doyle's class has 8. Mrs. Bauer's class has 6. Mr. Andrews' class has 2. Mrs. Aaron's class has 4. And Ms. Fernandez's class has 7. Days riding bikes to school. The first one is Annie. Then the second is Lewis, Kelly, Nancy, and Joe. But remember what we said? You need to look at what each thing represents. So each bike represents 3 days. How many days did Annie ride her bike to school? It would be 6. And how about Lewis? 3. What about Kelly? Okay, let's do it. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 days, right? How about Nancy?
There are three methods I can use to answer this question. I can skip count, like we've done, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. Or I can add 3 plus 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 3 equals 21. Or I can multiply. I can add the number of bikes, then multiply by the days being 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times 3 equals 21. What about Joe? 9 days.
Who rode to school the most days?
We can look at the picture graph. That's what makes it so nice. We can see quickly it was Nancy. How many days did Joe ride to school?
We can skip count. 3, 6, 9. Or we can add 3 plus 3 plus 3 equals 9. Or we can multiply. 3 times 3 equals 9. Joe rode 9 days.
Here we have a spigot.
A spigot is another name for faucet.
It equals 5 gallons of water.
The activities are
brushing your teeth, flushing a standard toilet, washing the dishes in the sink, or taking a 5-minute shower. The spigots are the number of gallons of water used.
When we look at our key or our legend, we see that one spigot or faucet equals 5 gallons of water.
How many gallons were used in brushing your teeth? We have definitely 5 plus half, so it'd be 6, 7 and a half. 7 and a half gallons. What about flushing a standard toilet? There are 3 of those, so it's 5 plus 5 plus 5 is 15. What about washing dishes in the sink?
5, 10, 15, 20 equals 20.
What about taking a 5-minute shower?
5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and a half
would be 27 and a half gallons of water used for taking a shower. Third grade classes. Here we have the number of students in the class. Each smile equals 3 students.
The teachers in the classroom are?
We have Ms. Smith, Mrs. Lee, Mr. Jones, Ms. Rose. Which teacher has 15 students?
To answer this question, we are going to start with Ms. Smith's class.
So we have to go 3 plus 3 is 6, 9, 12, 15. It's not Ms. Smith because she has 18 students. It's not Mrs. Lee because she has 9 students. Ah, it's Mr. Jones. He has 15 students.
3, 6, 9, 12, 15 equals 15,
or 3 times 5 equals 15. And Miss Rose, how many does she have? She, like Mrs. Lee, has 9.
Mr. Jones is the answer.
Which two teachers have the same number of students? Mrs. Lee and Miss Rose. Telegraphs. The use of a tally sticks goes back to the Stone Age, dating 30,000 BC. We still use tallies to represent numbers. Tallies, like you see here, are worth 5. And you can see the number of sticks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It helps us when we draw that line or diagonally, because then we can visualize that that's the 5th one We know it's 5. How is this information presented? A tally graph. And we're talking about favorite ice cream. Chocolate being 5, vanilla being 3, strawberry being 4, mint chocolate chip being 7, Rocky Road is 2, and cherry is 1. Players and water balloon toss. We have Jack and Jane, and then we have April and Crystal, and we also have Mark and Mary, and Ron and Mike. How many water balloons tosses did Jack and Jane and April and Crystal throw? Jack and Jane, that's the first one, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. April and Crystal, they threw 7. 25 plus 7 equals 32. How many water balloon tosses did Mark and Mary and Ron and Mike throw? Okay, Mark and Mary, that's the third one down. It's 5, 10, 15, 16. 16 for Mark and Mary. And how many did Ron and Mike throw? That's the fourth one down. It's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 26, 27, 28. Our answer would be 16 plus 28 equals 44. Mark and Mary and Ron and Mike threw a total of 44 water balloons. Mark pulled colored tiles from a bag. Each time he returned the tile to the bag, he recorded his findings in the chart below. We have the colored tiles being black, blue, green, red, and yellow, and the number of times the color is drawn. What color tiles were pulled the most? We can see by the tallies, we can see the most, and it would be green. What color tiles were pulled the least? Blue. Only 3 tiles were pulled. Bar graph. A bar graph that uses bars to show and compare data. How is this information presented? A bar graph is made. And here we're using the example of ice cream again. We have to know our variables. We're looking at students that liked ice cream, so students is a variable, and the types of ice cream. We have 6 at chocolate, 3 at vanilla, 5 at strawberry, 7 mint and chocolate chip, 2 at Rocky Road, and 1 at cherry. Here we're going to graph some shapes. Draw bars on the graph to show the number of sides for each pattern block. Let's look at the triangle. How many sides? 1, 2, 3. So there we have it. The next one, it's like a stop sign. It's an octagon, meaning 8. Then we have a diamond. How many sides to a diamond? 4. Here's a hexagon. Hex means 6. And the last one is a rectangle. Rectangles have 4 sides. Okay, which pattern block has the most sides? See, when you do this graphing, it's a visual. You can see immediately it's the octagon or the stop sign shape. Which bar on the graph shows the least number of sides? Again, it's easy to see because it's a bar graph. It's the triangle. Which pattern blocks have the same number of sides? It's the diamond and the rectangle. They both have 4. Look at this bar graph. It's turned sideways. Graphs in general can be different. You have to look very closely at the way it's designed. You look for the title, you look for the variables, whether it's colors or students, and you decide which value is given to each to find your answer. Students' favorite colors. Our colors are red, yellow, green, and purple. And then we have the number of students. How many students chose green as their favorite color? That's right, 6. How many students chose red as their favorite color? 2. Very good. How many students chose purple as their favorite color? Well, you have to look a little more carefully because it's between the numbers. It does not reach the line of the marks for the numbers. So it's A. It's 2.5 or 2.5. Now we're going to talk about the favorite time of the year. And we have the number of students going up to 30. And then we have winter, spring, summer, and fall, the time of the year. How many students chose spring and fall as their favorite time of the year? It's both of them, spring and fall. Spring has 15 and fall has 5. So you have to take 15 plus 5 and you would get 20. You could count by 5. 5, 10, 15, 20. That makes it easy. How many students chose summer, then winter, as their favorite time of the year? Summer has 25, and then winter has 10. The answer is 15. 15 more students chose summer. How many students voted for their favorite time of the year? Winter has 10. Spring has 15, so we go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and then 25 for summer makes 50, and then fall has 5, so the answer is 55. Pie graph. How is this information presented? A pie graph is made. A pie graph is also called a pie chart. Pie charts help you understand whole groupings of 100%. Pie charts use percentages based on 100. This is why you need to know how to count to 100. In this picture of favorite ice cream, you can see the grouping sizes. We need to first check the legend or key to determine what colors represent which ice cream. Again, we're dealing with favorite ice cream. We have chocolate being the maroon color, vanilla being the magenta, strawberry being red, mint chocolate chip being orange, and Rocky Road being yellow or golden. From this pie chart, we can see that most people liked mint chocolate chip the most. People liked Rocky Road the least. This is a sports graph. What is the largest percentage of sports played? And we see we have basketball 11%, baseball 25%, hockey 20%, and soccer 44%. So the picture helps a great deal. That's what's nice about using different kinds of graphs. We can see right away that the answer is soccer at 44%. What sport was played the least? Least meaning smallest. And we can see by the graph it's basketball being 11%. What is the percentage of basketball and hockey? So we take basketball being 11 and hockey being 20%. 11% plus 20% equals 31%. Line graph. A line graph that uses points and lines to show change over time. How is this information presented? It's a line graph. And again, you can see our ice cream example. This graph shows the number of walkers to school for 1 week. Use the graph to answer the questions.
We need to look at our variables.
Number of walkers and days of the week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. How many students walked on Wednesday? Ten.
Were there more walkers on Monday or Wednesday?
Monday.
There were 10 walkers on Wednesday and 20 walkers on Monday. Monday had more walkers.
Were there more walkers between Wednesday and Thursday or between Thursday and Friday?
There were 40 walkers on Thursday. There were 10 walkers on Wednesday. You take 40 and subtract the difference equals 30.
Walkers on Wednesday and Thursday. On Thursday, there were 40 walkers. On Friday, there were 60 walkers. Again, we have to subtract the difference. 60 minus 40 equals 20 walkers on Thursday and Friday. 30 is larger than 20, so we know Thursday and Friday had more walkers.
We need to read the title first to determine what the line graph is all about. People reading during 11 a.m. to 3 p.m.
What time was the greatest number of people reading? A. 3 p.m. B. 2 p.m. C. 1 p.m. or D. 12 p.m. The answer is D. 12 p.m.
Favorite pets. The kinds of pets we have: birds, cats, dogs, fish, hamsters. The number of votes: 5 for birds, 7 for cats, 11 for dogs, 2 for fish, 4 for hamsters. Which is the favorite pet? Dogs. Dogs are 11. That's the biggest number, so it's the favorite pet.
Using the information here about favorite pets, if you were to create a bar graph using this information, which bar would be the smallest? A. Bird. B. Cat. C. Dog. D. Fish. Or E. Hamster.
Fish. There's only 2 number of votes. How many more students chose cat than hamster as their favorite pet? Cat is 7 and hamster is 4. What is the difference between the two?
We can answer this problem in 2 ways. We can subtract 7 minus 4, or we can count up from the lowest number being 4 to 7.
How many more? So we go 5, 6, 7.
Because it took 3 numbers to move up to 7, we know
it's A, it's 3 more students. Stars earned for the hard work. We have it in reading, writing, and math. We have room 10, room 11, room 12, room 13. Which room earned the most stars in writing? So we have to look at the column where it says writing. We have to look at the largest number, and that's 15. So it's room 13. Room 13 had 15 stars for writing. How many stars in math did room 10 and 12 earn together? Room 10 for math, we have to go to the math column and look at the room 10, and it's 10. And room 12 got 9. So if we put those together, we would have 19.
10 plus 9 equals 19.
How many stars did room 11 earn in reading and writing altogether? Got to go to room 11, look at reading and writing. So room 11 got 10 for reading, and for writing, room 11 got 10. So if we put them together, 10 plus 10 equals 20. How many more stars in reading did room 11 earn than 13? Room 11 got 10, and room 13 got 8. So 9, 10.
I count up to get the answer.
2.
This is a challenge for older students to create their own line graph using the information provided.
Use this data to make a line graph to show the growth of Mike's plant in centimeters. Make sure that you title your graph. Title the vertical axis, title the horizontal axis. Horizontal means left to right, means across. Vertical means up and down. Like you look up and you look down, the line would go up and down. So I hope that was a help. Indicate your measurement scale. We're working in centimeters.
You can let me know how you did in the comments below.
Today we learned so much about graphing. We covered pictographs, tallies, bar graphs, pie graphs, and line graphs. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. If it was a help, please subscribe and give a like. Thank you so much for watching. Take care till next time, and keep learning every day.
Check out these books for their academic usefulness.